our CTAE programs, students competing at national events this summer. We have, what I know of right now, a lot of the state competitions are just finishing up, so we're getting the results in. Portal has Dr. Marshall's FFA team going on to nationals in October for horticulture. We have FCCLA from Statesboro High School. They'll be going to Atlanta for nationals in July. We have Southeast Bullock High School host of one going to Dallas for nationals in June. So there's a lot going on. Among those teams is our Skills USA team from Statesboro High. They will also be moving on to nationals. And that is the group that you have here tonight. And I'll let Mr. Matthew White, the construction teacher from Statesboro High and Skills USA advisor, give you an update on their project and what they're doing.
First, we'd like to thank the board and superintendent, everyone, for letting them come to practice. This is what this is for them. It's showcasing what they do, but this is also practice because they're fixing to have to go against 40 to 50 of the best from around the country in the end of June. And the more practice they can get in front of people, the more grind they can go through, the better off they'll be when they get there. The competition they're doing is called Career Pathway Showcase. It's designed to take students and allow them to create a project and then take that project and showcase it to the community and industry and show them what their pathway is all about. And construction has been lumped in with industry and engineering, which means STEM and all of these other programs. So at the state level, they're going against every college and career academy, every high school from around the state of Georgia that has an engineering industry STEM program. And they're having to take construction and showcase to people why it's as relevant now as it ever has been, and take the project they've done and showcase how it's beneficial to the community. And so what they're going to do here is they're going to go through just a brief summary in their presentation of what this is. Before they start, I do want to mention to the foundation members that one of the grants that we received 2 years ago, I believe, actually helped pay for the drone that allowed them to make this part of the technology use as possible. And we'd like to thank y'all for that, to showcase how we've integrated into what we're still learning. And so I'm going to turn it over to these gentlemen. Before I do that, again, I forget to mention, we found out today from the Lieutenant Governor that Jamin actually received a $500 scholarship from the Lieutenant Governor for help cover his travel costs.
Thank you for the opportunity for us to practice our presentation. This is pretty scary for us, but we'll get through. Now, we chose a duck pond for our project, and that's not very typical. You don't have blueprints for a duck pond, so you wouldn't imagine a construction team going for a duck pond, right? But actually, the duck pond was started by a science class at Statesboro High School. They just didn't have the funds to continue the project. And as students, we really wanted to pick it up. We wanted to show them what we could do. We also didn't have the money to do this project. So what we did is we went through Skills USA and got a loan that was funded by Lowe's. And we estimated we needed about $6,000 to complete this project. We were pretty close. Now, with this project, we wanted to show not only our school, but our community that we're not just a shop class teaching this old construction techniques. We do everything from electrical to plumbing to masonry and, of course, carpentry. And we wanted a project that would demonstrate all these aspects of our field. And we like to refer ourselves as Construction 2.0. We use top-of-the-line technology, drone that was helped pay for. Now, I'm not really an expert with the drone, but Mr. Wakefield is, and I'd like to turn it over to him.
So again, I'd like to thank you for having us here tonight for our practice that we have competition at the end of June in Kentucky. And now I'd like to talk to you a little more about how we use something like this in, say, our industry and our Construction 2.0 class. Now I'd like to start out with an application that works to make this thing, I guess you could say, worthwhile using. So it's a website called Drone Deploy, and what that allows you to do is digital image stitching, which actually allows you to lay pictures over itself, and it maps out and it makes a 3D rendering of the, say, duck pond. And now you're probably wondering how all this relates back to construction, and present to you Mr. Jamin Dell to explain.
First of all, thank you for having us today. And this is my first year in the program. I've learned so much, and we all have learned so much through this 1 year that we've been working on this duck hunt. First of all, we learned safety. Safety is really important because all of us want to go home with two hands and two feet. So safety is a really key aspect. We couldn't really do anything without learning about the basics of safety. And then we also have mathematics. If we didn't have mathematics, nothing in construction would be possible. You would think that without mathematics you could do so much, but mathematics is really important. Calculating board feet and 2x6s and everything like that. We use mathematics. If you have a mistake in mathematics, there could be a delay in time or a problem that might occur. But we'd like to have all of our mathematics correct and our calculations correct. And we also learned more about power tools and hand tools. Power tools are really important because if we didn't have them, we'd be working by hand, and that would really suck. And we also learned about blueprint reading. And we always want to learn more about blueprints, because if we didn't have blueprints, then we wouldn't be able to build what we're building at the outdoor classroom. And these are just some basic fasteners that we used at the duck pond and hurricane ties, screws, just to keep the platform together. And also, we had a major concern at the duck pond because we had no electricity. So we used all battery-powered materials and machinery to work out on the duck pond. And that's basically it. That was our presentation. But if you have any questions, feel free to ask.
Great job, man.
One of the things I failed to mention was that Isaac is actually leaving after junior year to go to basic training, and so we had to. Brian is stepping in, who helped write the grant, so he's going to be stepping in as the other team member to go to nationals. And I meant to introduce him earlier. This is Brian Escudero, just finished his third year of the program this year, pathway completer. Thank y'all very much. And guys, if you want to cut the TV off, and then we can.